Hello, this is Victor and I am the Director of Content Accessibility with BlueDAG. Today we are going to go through a brief overview of measuring slopes from the accessible parking space to the main entrance of a building. I'm going to start by measuring the width of both the parking stall and access aisle. For details on measuring the width of parking stalls and access aisles, you can visit our website and view our past videos on the subject. Now I'm ready to begin checking for excessive slopes for the parking space. As you can see, I've attached a strap to my level. This is helpful when taking so many readings because it speeds up my process and it's less taxing on my back. In accessible parking spaces and access aisles, changes in level are not permitted other than slopes up to 1 in 48 or approximately 2.1%. Here, the slope was 3 to 4%. I'm going to document this using our BlueDAG mobile app on my phone. I'll take a reference shot and close-up shot of the measurement and type in my reading. Then I can continue. The landing at the bottom of parallel curb ramps like this one must have a length of at least 4 feet, but 5 feet is preferred. They must also be as wide as the ramp. Curb ramps shall have a running slope no greater than 1 in 12 or 8.3%, with some exceptions. Cross slopes of curb ramps shall not be greater than 1 in 48 or 2.1%. An accessible route must connect directly to access aisles. They shall have a clear width of 36 inches minimum, with some exceptions. The cross slope of the walking surface shall not be greater than 1 in 48, and the running slope shall not be greater than 1 in 20, or 5%.